We are literally at this transition of changing from a centuries-old tradition of the way we teach surgeons to a new way of teaching. Fundamentally and conceptually, we would all agree that learning skills incrementally from the most basic to the most complicated is the right way to learn. We know this from many examples in life. Athletics is a perfect example. You would never tell a person to, for example, watch a videotape of somebody swinging a golf club and then hand them a golf club. That's not the way we teach. Or telling a person, watch the star soccer player run. You have to teach them how to run in the first place, how to kick the ball, how to move. So I think that there's plenty of examples where teaching fundamentals has been proven to be the best way to learn. But on the other hand, we need to demonstrate that the education actually has an impact on patient care, and that's been done. I think of it in two broad categories, and I think the first category is resident training. The second category is education for surgeons in practice and assessment of surgeons in practice. And so in the former case, when it comes to residency training, I can't think of any program nationally or internationally where arthroscopic procedures are common where it wouldn't be relevant. So the question is why? What's the return on investment? There's a couple of different ways to think about this. The first would be the potential to bring trainees up the learning curve outside of patient care. There's really no reason any longer for the patients to suffer our learning curves if there's technology that can replace that. Bad outcomes cost money. If simulation can be used to improve our outcomes, it also improves economics. But the other is efficiency in the operating room. If part of the education can be done in a laboratory environment, in a simulated environment, then that inefficiency can be pulled out of the operating room. And as I foresee it, this technology is going to ramp up exponentially in the near future. So in my mind, what will be possible is bordering on unimaginable now.